right, this time we got the Giant Cedars Nature Trail that we're going to go on. Mount Revelstoke National Park up in BC. As Christopher Columbus was crossing the Atlantic on his first voyage to the New World in 1492, many of these cedars and hemlocks were seedlings. By the time Leonardo da Vinci's last brush stroke on the Mona Lisa had dried, which was 1506, these seedlings had become saplings. As audiences watched the inaugural performance of William Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet in 1595, these forest giants had already been alive for more than a century. It's absolutely crazy. Let's go see some big trees today. I'm having Heather run back to the car real quick and grab some bear spray. Might edit that part out. I'd like to mention once again that if you're coming this way, you want to take bear spray with you, but in Canada, you cannot cross the border from the United States unless your bear spray says that it's for bears specifically. If it says anything about use on humans, you can't bring it across. They will confiscate it from you. They'll probably hate you if you don't declare it. But if it says bear spray, it's perfectly okay. And as you can see, got some decently big cedars to begin with. And here comes Heather now. Say hi, baby. Let's walk up to the first sign here. You hear her taking pictures behind me, you'll hear the camera snap. But that's only because I want her to take pictures so we can have pictures of our own on here. And this one's in French. Which is kind of funny because I actually can read most of that. Oh, here we go. Giant Cedars, the last stand. Old growth forests are dynamic. Natural communities operating on timetables very different from our own. I'll go ahead and let you read the rest. On most of these videos, I'll just pause for a few seconds at your sign so you can hit pause and read them if you wish. Then we'll continue on. And of course, that's the best part right there, no smoking. If you're gonna come out to nature, you know, you might as well not smoke. If you're gonna smoke, you know, yeah. Everybody who knows me knows how I feel about smoking. I don't like it. And if you're a smoker, try and quit. It's healthier for you, and you'll be able to go on more walks like this one. As we can see, we got plenty of stairs here, so unfortunately, wheelchairs probably are not gonna access this unless you've got treads. These are some pretty nice big trees. I just want to give you a little view here. Here's Heather. There's the tree. It's pretty decent size for a cedar, and they're only getting bigger. Look at the base of this one. Now, we've been to the redwoods before, and they have some of the most massive trees in the world. If I can find a way to put it in the video, I'll put one of the pictures of me standing next to one. There were some massive sized trees. So we've got a trail register. I guess somebody skipped half, well, more than half a page. This is 15th of June, I guess they're all, well, this is 2016, wow. There you go. Today's the 25th of June. It's crazy how majestic this feels. You know, I'm just in awe knowing that these trees have lived so much longer and will be here long after I'm gone. It's amazing how we can just rip our forests apart just for the wood instead of growing them on land and growing up smaller ones and cutting them back down and renewing the resource. We go after these big, huge monsters just because it got more wood, and that's just wrong, I think. I don't think we have any right killing something that's been here so long. I mean, these are ancient. At least 600 years. Makes you wonder what kind of fire went through. And devastated this place in order to get these to drop and sprout. See, this one here looks like we're gonna have a little bit of a climb. Luckily, they're only half steps. We got the mossy side too going on. Say, but we've been through much, much worse though, as far as hikes go. Like I said before, we're more than likely going to have people, because it is a national park and all. Just astounded by how large everything is. Good day, folks. Green all the way to the top of the hill. It's exactly what I've noticed about British Columbia. It's like it's all the way up, it's green. It's not like our national forests where you can see a bunch of brown. This looks more like our national forest where we have a bunch of brown in between there. But the ones in BC, you see mostly green all the way up, every little bit, every little drop, green. I'm not sure whether that's because they haven't cut any down or whether it's because most of the forest they reserve for to be untouched, so I don't even think humans have tread in areas like that. So nature just takes over. Gives you stuff like this. See, this is like the ascend of 1,000 stairs, huh? They're barely over a plank, two planks high, like 2.5 planks. I mean, this is a real easy staircase. I guess this is a sitting bench for anybody who can't make it up in one go. There goes a bird. I suppose I shouldn't have scared him so we could get a better view and identify him. This only gets better though. Look at how dense this forest is too. Just these cedars. Bear bears and caribou. Now, I wouldn't mind seeing a caribou. I've never seen one before in person. Have seen the bears, though, up in Yellowstone, or no, in Glacier National Park on the state side. Going to Glacier in BC later on today. We'll have videos of that later. This is really cool too. I love how you can see the root systems when they fall over and die. It's just amazing the networks that they had in the ground. Draw the water out. I mean, dishevels whole entire stones and takes them with them up in the roots. This one's got like several boulders. Hear the birds way up there. And we're back, looking at bats and voles. Up the tree where he just took pictures. Come down. Take a look at some of the deadfall here. This looks pretty fresh. You can tell by how red it still looks and it's not looking rotten. Wow, see the green on the outside? That had been the most recent growth before it either snapped or got nailed by lightning. I'm gonna say it snapped. This lightning usually leaves a scar. See all the little trails left by insects. See, cedars naturally insect repellent and rot resistant, but that doesn't mean that there aren't ones that do like to eat it. This whole place is just lush and green. The stairs are coming down. Forgot to check at the board exactly how long this walk is. I mean, it's not a bad walk, just not accessible for people with wheelchairs, unfortunately. I suppose if you had crutches, you could get up. They're not the most difficult stairs of all. Real nice and easy. You can hear the running water. It's probably the same creeks that spill into some of the other places here going down to the Columbia. This again telling how old the trees are. I pretty much read this at the beginning of the video. Over the edge here. See, just a little bit of running water. Nothing really big. Just sounds like a lot coming off the walls. See, this is a really old tree right here, you can tell, because the wood's all weathered and everything. It's a lot different than the one we saw earlier. And of course, it's now half rotten out too. So you can really tell the difference with the color. more cool looking roots. Had a little spider web attached to it. A little string goes to the boardwalk. I tell you, those little late legged guys will attach to anything. Seen some crazy stuff. It's just running water everywhere here. Like I said, last few days it's been raining pretty good. Been on vacation, hasn't stopped us from going to a few places. You see in the distance there, little rapid falls there, little steps. It's really neat. That'd almost be something that I'd like to see in a garden. It's pretty amazing. Go ahead and grab a couple pictures. I might come up to the sign and wait. Why are the old growth forests special? Yeah, watch those steps that are right behind me when I read those signs. So we had a storm a few years ago, and I'm pretty sure that probably snapped that one. As I just turn and do the same thing that you did. So you gotta watch the stairs around here, folks. As you can see, there's the stairs going back down to the parking lot. This is the giant old growth cedars up in Mount Revelstoke National Park, BC, Canada.